almost Thanksgiving, which means we're about to enter into one of the busiest shopping periods of the year. Downtown Sioux Falls retailers are joining in on the fun by encouraging you to shop small this weekend for Small Business Saturday. Here to tell us how they are getting ready to help cross off the items on your shopping list this Saturday are Terry Schuver and Melanie Cotton with Sticks and Steel. Thanks so much for coming in today, ladies.
Oh, thanks for having us.
Yes.
So, Melanie, explain to me what Small Business Saturday is. What's the purpose?
Oh, it's so fun. It's just a great way to encourage shoppers to support their local businesses, especially in the downtown area.
And Terry, how did this get started?
Well, surprisingly, it started with a large corporation, American Express. Initiated Small Business Saturday 8 or 9 years ago nationally. And year by year, it's grown and the participation has grown. I would say 4 or 5 years ago, it really took hold locally. And we've had great crowds ever since.
So how long has Sticks and Steel been a part of this? If this started back in 2010, it's only been around, you know, DTSF as an event more in the recent years, but how long has Sticks and Steel been apart?
You know, I think we participated maybe the second year that it started. We accept American Express, so we were sent the information and we logged in and tried to put ourselves on the map, so to speak. It was a little, we didn't know what we were doing, let's just put it that way. But as other neighbors and Downtown Sioux Falls members figured it out, we all started to do our little bit to promote it and the crowds followed.
So if it was American Express that started this, Terry, why did you decide to get on board with this right away?
You know, it's really an interesting win-win-win kind of situation. Obviously, American Express wins, they get exposure. The small businesses win because they also get exposure. And then the consumer wins because there's some rebates if you use your American Express card. So it's really fun to participate in things that everybody wins.
And Melanie, how does this affect our economy as a whole?
It's
for those small businesses. Like, does this play a role a lot in Sticks and Steel this day?
Oh, absolutely. It's a huge day for us.
Those tax dollars are circulate through the community. The effects of those tax dollars last all year long. And I think the exposure is huge for the consumer to see what a small business does as opposed to what happens when they shop online. The personal contact, they may, you know, see products that they didn't know existed in the community. It's really something that happens that day, but it goes throughout the whole year. The effects last a long time, 365 days.
Oh, wow. So, Melanie, if I were to go shopping, what can a small business offer like Sticks and Steel over a big store that I can go to at the mall?
Oh, it's such, really, it's about the experience. We're not really promoting any special deals. We're really promoting solid family time and community. We are offering fun little, we're giving away reindeer food to our customers. We're giving mom and dad, like, a fun little beverage that they can drink while they're shopping. It's really more about the experience.
And we have a graphic to pull up about why we should shop local. So just if you want to elaborate on this a little bit more for these different reasons, Terry.
Well, we do build community, I think, when we spend time with each other as opposed to in front of a computer. Obviously, that's pretty, and strengthening, you know, anything that you spend in town stays in town. Those, you're employing local folks, you're, you know, paying tax dollars, all those things. The environment, I think, I'm not sure if you're talking about the air environment or just the environment of the community, but certainly the community benefits from feeling more neighbor-like. And there's more choices. When you shop locally, you've got choices that are more individualized, I think, as opposed to, you know, big box, same thing, just a different price. You know, the choices are more personal.
How does this day also play a role, Terry, in getting customers in the door that maybe have never even stopped by Sticks and Steel or other small businesses?
You know, we think that we're seeing a change in, well, I shouldn't say a change, maybe an addition to some family traditions that started, you know, when Black Friday shopping started. I think there's lots of families that, you know, do their Thanksgiving dinner and either go out that night or the next morning, and it's just good family fun shopping time. We're starting to see that on Small Business Saturday, too. They'll do their Friday thing, and then they do their Saturday thing, and they're two very different experiences. Generally, there's not, you know, lines that are 200 people long on Small Business Saturday.
You don't have to be in a tent.
Yeah.
You don't have to wait outside in a tent.
It's generally a little more relaxed and a little more personal. I do think we're really seeing some great traditions that, you know, families just do it year after year. It's part of their deal.
And has this grown since it's really started down here as a...
Most definitely. Okay. Most definitely. I would say either 4 or 5 years ago, it was a beautiful day, in that Saturday in particular, and we looked at each other and said, holy moly, I think everybody just got this.
Yeah.
And it's been really great ever since. It's a really busy, fun day.
All right, well, let's go over the details so everyone can get this on their calendar, but it's on November 24th. It's Small Business Saturday, so that's a great time. Get out, cross those items off your Christmas list, shopping, and just really get out and support those businesses. So
thank you.
Thank you so much. And you can also find a list online for other businesses that are participating in Small Business Saturday. Thank you so much, ladies, for coming in today.
Thank you for having us.